So what's the deal with Brooklyn and the New York Islanders? We're not going to know anytime soon, but during the New York Islanders game Thursday night with the Philadelphia Flyers, they dropped a little bit of a surprise during the first intermission in the form of an open and clear interview between Howie Rose and Brooklyn developer Bruce Ratner. Of course, during that interview, Bruce Ratner said, as he'd said in the past too, that he hopes the Islanders find some arrangement that works for Charles Wong in their current location, but if that doesn't work out, of course he would love to see them in Brooklyn. The interview was a fairly lengthy chance for Ratner to sort of sell fans almost more than the Islanders themselves on the amenities and access to the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. As far as a PR move, well, we've seen this several times in the past throughout this saga, not just within the last few years with the Lighthouse Project and the referendum last summer, but even well before that, and even under previous ownerships. This has been a two-decade-long saga, and there have been all sorts of PR stunts to build pressure on politicians and the citizens who, in theory, elect them to make a change and have the county and the town of Hempstead approve some sort of viable plan to replace Nassau Coliseum. Unfortunately, it's a horrible economic time to do that, both for the county and for the nation overall. And the lease, which has kept this going on forever and ever and ever, is still there, and it still doesn't expire until 2015. So while this is a nice bone to throw for fans, it's probably not a very significant political move to amp up the pressure and say, hey, yes, we're truly considering Brooklyn, even if they didn't come out and say that. But by tacitly having Ratner on there and saying it by proxy, you sort of have that message sent. The saga is just going to continue. It's going to be a slow, methodical process with little release valves like this. With the interview with Ratner. The next big step is probably next fall when that preseason game happens. And we'll see how fans respond and we'll see what the political environment is at that time. But aside from that, onward we march to 2015 where we'll see where the Islanders end up. I'm Dominic Kansky with LighthouseHockey.com and this has been our 3-Minute Island update on SB Nation's YouTube channel.